last class I was discussing about valuation of goodwill. What is the meaning of goodwill? What is the importance? What are the methods and what are the determinants to be considered at the time of valuation of goodwill? As well as I worked out some simple problem in relation to valuation of goodwill. Now, today I am going to discuss about complicated problems. Now, the first problem, I will write down in the board. What is the problem? What is the problem? Total assets, rupees 1 lakhs, total liabilities rupees 40,000, profit earned in last 5 years, first year 20,000, second year 25,000, third year 15,000, fourth year 10,000, fifth year 20,000. Normal rate of return 10%. Normal rate of return 10%. Managerial remuneration 2,000. Goodwill of the firm to be valued on the basis of 3 year purchase of super profit. 3 year purchase of super profit. This is a problem. In this particular problem, total asset is given, total liability is given. Thereafter, the profit for the last 5 years is given. Managerial remuneration is also given. Normal rate of return is given. And goodwill to be calculated on the basis of super profit method. I will do only super profit here than the other methods. Other methods. Generally, you can't get other methods in this type of problem. Generally, they will ask super profit only. I will work out super profit method. How to calculate super profit. Now, first step, calculation of average capital employed. Calculation of average capital employed is a first step to be followed at the time of calculation of goodwill. Calculation of average capital employed. Now, while calculation of average capital employed, first you should take total assets is 1 lakh here, less total liabilities. The total liability here is 40,000. You will get 60,000. From that, less half of the current year profit. Half of the current year profit. Here current year means one year also. 20,000, but directly 20,000 cannot be taken. Here there is a non-recurring profit. It's a managerial remuneration. So that should be deducted 2,000. Thereafter half. You will get 18,000 half, that is 9,000. So average capital employed to be 51,000. Now, the second step, this is the first step, second step. Calculation of expected profit. Calculation of expected profit. The formula here is average capital employed into normal rate of return. Normal rate of return. Average capital employed into normal rate of return. We got average capital employed as 51,000 into normal rate of return here is 10%. So to be 5,100. Now, two step is over. Third step, calculation of average adjusted profit. Calculation of average adjusted profit. Now, while talking about calculation of average adjusted profit, we are supposed to take profits 20,000 plus 25,000 plus 15,000 plus 10,000 plus 20,000 divided by 5. 20, 45, 60, 70, 90,000. Total should be 90,000 divided by 5. You will get here 18,000 as average profit. 18,000 as average profit. See here, 20 plus 25, 45. Plus 15, 60. 60 plus 10, 70. 70 plus 20, 90. 90,000 divided by 5 to be 18,000. 18,000. Now, average adjusted profit is equal to 18,000 minus managerial remuneration is 2,000, should be 16,000. Fourth step here is calculation of super profit. Calculation of super profit. We know that. What is the formula for super profit? Super profit is equal to average profit. Adjusted profit minus expected profit. Average adjusted is 16,000. Expected profit already we found. Expected profit already we found. Already we found as 5,100. So super profit is equal to this minus this, that should be 10,900. Now, last step here is goodwill is equal to super profit into number of year of
first is number of year of purchase. So what is the profit here is 10,900 into number of year of purchase is 3. So you're supposed to multiply this 32,700.
This is the last step to find goodwill under super profit method. Now I will teach you one more method here.
Goodwill calculation of goodwill under capitalization of average profit or capitalization of super profit. So for this you are supposed to apply the formula goodwill is equal to super profit into 100 divided by normal rate of return. So super profit we found here 10,900 into 100 divided by 10. So this should be 1,09,000 as goodwill.
This is way we are supposed to find or you are supposed to calculate what is the value of goodwill under super profit method.